The question is, $17 a pop, will the shares pop?
You know, it depends a lot on what the investor demand is in the aftermarket. What we've seen is that these companies can have a lot of volatility. In the case of Twitter, it popped a lot. In the case of Facebook, it struggled to hold its IPO price.
Alex, 10 times oversubscribed is what we've been reporting. $17 a share. Is there enough, do you think, being left on the table? As Chi-Hua was pointing out, it's hard to muster these things, but Twitter certainly did.
It did, and you have to remember Facebook had the trading day glitch as well. So some of that is playing into it. The oversubscription, I will caveat that by saying investors tend to put in orders bigger than what they actually want because everyone's fighting for allocation for these really buzzy companies. But the it seems like they don't want it to fly off the charts. Folks don't want this idea that you've left money on the table. Yeah. So we will be definitely watching from the floor tomorrow to see what happens and, you know, to see if there is as much demand as there is buzz around this listing.
Because it seems as though many of the orders came in at about the $17 to $18 range. Certainly Morgan Stanley, Goldman Sachs leading the underwriting want to see that it's not too much money left on the table. David Kirkpatrick, you've been telling me that actually this is a nosebleed valuation.
Well, I still think it is. On the other hand, there's a nosebleed's worth of demand. So I think there's a huge amount of people who really just want to get in on the hot new thing, who see this as the first opportunity of its type in a number of years. And I suspect a lot of them are still out there in the marketplace after the IPO as well. So I would expect the stock will go up somewhat after the IPO.
Chi-Hua, you have so much experience in this. You helped Chegg, you helped Twitter come to the market. And the daily active users is something that's been striking the market in particular. There was a slowdown shown by Snapchat's daily average user growth, whereas that wasn't the case of Facebook and Twitter. Do you think that's a cause of concern?
Yeah, I think that's actually the biggest concern facing the company right now, is they really need to find a way to re-accelerate their user growth. If you look at them compared to Facebook and Twitter at the same point when they were going public, Snapchat is growing half as fast as Facebook and Twitter were on a quarter-on-quarter basis. And as you track the trajectories of Facebook and Twitter since their public offerings, it really is a tale of two cities. Facebook has continued to grow at a really rapid clip while Twitter has slowed down.
I mean, but Alex, thinking back to Facebook, it took a couple of years to prove that their strategy in mobile was the right one, and David knows this well. Can you talk to us about the daily active users? They might be less, far less than Instagram, 158 million users, but they are addicted.
They are, and that's kind of the bet for Snap, is they, you heard them push on the roadshow, we're not trying to win everyone everywhere for the platform. We want them to be more engaged. We did see some, you know, hinks with engagement as well, but they're trying to keep folks in the platform, and that's how they're trying to bring in advertisers. Again, it's still so early in their money-making process. They've only been making real revenue for about 2 years.
It's already more than 400 million.
It is more than 400 million, but when you compare that to the big peers, that still just drops in the bucket. As they continue to pitch themselves to advertisers, they need to really prove that that is the right thing for them to be going toward and that they can keep users on the platform, especially if growth continues to kind of falter.
David, it's interesting, of course, a lot of the chat has also been about the control that, of course, the two key co-founders maintain.
Yes.
And this is something, maybe a leaf out of the book of Google and Facebook, which have steadily taken control back as leaders of the business, but they were already proven. How much do you think you're seeing this being talked about in the market and people now trying to push back, even regulators?
Well, it's taking something that Zuckerberg, in effect, began in sort of these kinds of companies by essentially retaining control to an extreme in the sense that they're giving absolutely no control whatsoever to the shareholders. And my feeling in terms of what they have to ignite, not reignite, is actual profits. Facebook had money coming in. You know, they have $400 million in revenue, but $500 million in losses. That's a $900 million, span there. So they got some serious work to do to actually make a real business that makes profits. Now, bringing in money from the IPO will help them fund that and also develop new capabilities. But I'm a little skeptical about this as a business still.